In this lesson, we are going to learn how to inspect variable values in different ways using VS Code. Now here I have a sample program called debug person, and here I have created some primitive values like integer I equals to 0, j equals to 100, etc. and different other data types and collections. So at line number 21, you can see there is a list of person objects created. At line number 23, there is a map of integer and person objects created. And finally, these are printed. Now, at the very end, I'm going to place a breakpoint, line number 27. And one thing we would ensure that in the breakpoint section, these two uncaught exceptions and caught exceptions, we are going to uncheck them in case they are checked. And I'm going to run this in debug mode. So under this run and debug, I'm clicking this run and debug button. The breakpoint should be hit at the very last line. So as expected, at the very last line, the breakpoint is hit. Now, how to inspect the different variables? So here, the very first thing what we can do, we have this variables section here under local variables. What we have the integers, the primitive values that are shown. Now, here I have created a number array at line number 15 and I have populated with 1000 items. So I have the number array over here. It's showing that yes, it has 1000 elements. If I expand this, this is the value where I can see the different values or different items inside this. Next, we have this person list. If I scroll over here, this is my person list. Now here I can see the person list. This is an array list. Its size is 8. If I expand this, I have all the items here, all the 8 items I can view from here. Now, if I expand this, the individual items, depending on their data type, we can see the values. So I can see this is the person object, age, country, name, all this I can view over here. So to inspect variables, one option we can see is the variable section. From here, I can see the different values. Let me close this. Now, let me expand this person map and scroll down. Here I can see 2 items. I can see the key and value. See, 0 and hash map node, 1 and hash map node. But the value, if I see here in the code, this map should contain integer that I can see as key. But the value should be person. But what about this person? So here if you see this I like icon, you click on here, click to expand. If I expand this now, you can see this is the key, this is the value. Expand it further. Here you can see all the details of the item over here, the value over here. So in this way, we can view this collection. The last thing is the first person, the person object. If I see over here, it's just a person object. Let me expand this. So it shows all the fields over here. So variable section we have seen. Another way to inspect the variables is the inline view. If you see this code right now, the breakpoint is hit and program is pausing. Beside each and every line, whatever values we have, if you see line number 20, the value of I is shown over here. Line number 21, this person list is shown over here, but it is not that much user friendly. It's only showing the object type and the size, right? So it is good for primitive values. For collections and all, this inline values or inline view is not that much effective. Apart from variables and inline view, there is another utility which is watch. Now in watch, what we can do, we can add expression and we can inspect the values over here. Suppose I have I and j over here and I want to check the value of I. I can add I over here, press enter. Okay, I is 100. I can check any custom expression like I plus j. That is also fine. Let me add any custom collection. Let me copy this. And here, removing this plus, control V, enter. Here, similar kind of view we will be seeing. Like this is the item. And within this item, I can see the detailed view over here. So we have checked variables section. We have checked watch. We have checked inline views. Let me elaborate a little bit on the watches. Watch I can add over here and I can remove them also. I can remove all of them together by clicking over here, remove all expressions. Now from here, if I click the variable, I can right click, and here I can say add to watch. In that way also it would be added to watch. From variable section also, if there is a variable, say I or J, it is shown. If I right click, there I can do add to watch. And individually I can remove them from here, like remove expression or remove all expression. So watch, variable and inline views we have covered. Another way is to use the debug console. Suppose I want to view a particular element, and from here whatever the default values it is showing, that is fine, but I want something custom. Say for example, here in watch I have seen, okay, this is my personal list. I want to see, in case it is a big one, maybe I want to see the 200 variables or 300 variables or whatever it is. What I can do here, I can go to debug console. And I can write person list dot get. Anyways, I don't have the 200 elements here, but if I expression, but if I enter a custom index, right, and press enter, it would be giving me the output over here. And if I expand this, I can see all the values. So debug console is another way to inspect the variables. Overall, at a high level, we have seen four options: using the variable section, using the watch section, using the inline view, as well as the debug console. So this features really helps us to understand the state of the program or the state of the variables in a useful way.